today. From M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland, this is the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Lamar Jackson and the Baltimore Ravens taking on Kirk Cousins and the Atlanta Falcons.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL on this fine afternoon brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you and I, we've done a lot of games together. Always seems like we're rehashing the same storylines. Turnovers, of course, always a big story. Quarterback play, running backs, yada, yada, yada. But getting ready for this one word kept coming to mind, and that's preparation.
Well, it's critical to be prepared physically, mentally. When you think about getting ready for an NFL game, you have to wonder, what will they throw at us that maybe we haven't seen before? Two-minute drill, maybe different things like that. Got to be prepared. You're exactly right.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. That's going to be taken at the goal line, and he'll return it. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. So the Falcons make their way out behind their new quarterback for 2024, signed back in March, the veteran Kirk Cousins.
And coming off of an offseason where Kirk Cousins was coming back from an Achilles injury, he thought that was going to be his biggest challenge. Instead, the Falcons drafted Michael Penix out of Washington in the first round. And while that was a jolt, Kirk Cousins has a great ability to just shake things off, move forward, and let his talents come through.
Cousins looking to put it up right away. A complete to Drake London. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 12 yards on the gain. A great start for this offense.
London moves the chains here, which is not unusual because that's something he did on over 65% of his receptions a season ago. Plenty of new pieces in place. Quarterbacks, Kirk Cousins, Michael Penix, whoever's going to throw the ball to him. He's hoping he can finally...
And oh, right away, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Raiders. There he goes, left side. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. The pass receiver turned into a runner, then he turned into a fumbler, and it goes the other way for six.
I love your description. Although for the offense, they're not too happy about it. But for the defense, what a big-time play for them. Never give up on anything. Sometimes you create your own points.
But the receiver, hard to fault him. He's just going for extra yards.
That's exactly what you're supposed to do, but you have to take care of the football.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now, the question, was the knee, in fact, down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Off the play fake, Cousins. A throw left sideline falls incomplete. After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Here's Cousins. Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off by Trenton Simpson. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back for the score.
And I think that's a signal for how this defense wants to play. They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And the Ravens lead at 7-0. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From out of his end zone, it's Avery Williams. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense. First carry of the game now for the Texas superstar, Bijan Robinson. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of four.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second and six. Now Cousins. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down. To throw, Cousins. Short throw caught by Pitts. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Cousins. He'll fire deep looking for more. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
That's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up. Converged on his man and broke the play up.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. On play action, Cousins. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 14 yards through the air, caught the D off guard on third and one.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off. And then you can't catch up in time to prevent the completion.
And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. So they cite the right guard this time with a holding penalty.
And so many different assignments you can have at that position, and sometimes you might just be a step too late and have to grab and hold on.
Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And he'll be stopped up at the line of scrimmage with a flag down. Let's check on the call. So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. Brought down on the play by Trenton Simpson. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Cousins now on second down. That's complete to Mooney. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
Even against double coverage, he found enough of an opening for a noticeable gain. Two guys on him, yet he finds a way to uncover downfield for the completion.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Cousins to throw it. And that is incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this will stay at a 7-point game. Baltimore gets set to take the field. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10.
And anytime you see a kicker trot out to try one from 56 yards, you know everything's got to come off perfectly for it to have a chance. If the laces aren't quite right, if he doesn't hit the fat part of the ball just right, it's unlikely to go through. And that one winds up no good.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 46. They'll start by running the option to the right. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And the Falcons grab it, and to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line, that's where they'll take over. So that play, I mean, it was pretty well blown up from the start, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, and when you're running the option like that as a quarterback, you have so many different keys and reads to make that sometimes as you're making them, you're not protecting the ball the way you should, and it gets popped free.
Cousins now after the fumble recovery. Short throw caught by Pitts. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
And his play caller does a nice job of giving him an easy throw to start this drive, and he takes advantage of it. The completion sets up a manageable second down.
Second down and a little more than a yard here. Moore, the motion man right. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get them a first down. And it continues to test the defense. They
have to... Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And the Ravens are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line.
And, partner, I think this is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack, because there's still three full quarters left in this one. More than enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Second quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession, as they've got it with a second and four coming up. From the gun, Jackson looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
So this defense coming up with a takeaway, and maybe that's something that can bring a little life to that sideline.
Well, I don't want to say that they've been sleepwalking through this first half, because that's simply not true, but you're right. We haven't seen a lot of fire from these guys, really, on either side of the ball. So maybe that's the catalyst that they needed to get them back into this game.
Atlanta prepped and ready for its next possession. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Following the interception, Cousins. Short throw caught by Pitts. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target.
From the 31, here comes second and a yard.
Out of the gun, they give to Robinson. And he'll go down at the 28. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
First and 10, Cousins targeting Moore, and he's got him on the crossing pattern. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. Now second and 3. On the counter, this is Robinson. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
The offense on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Cousins. That is caught. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. To throw is Cousins. Now throw right side here, going to be incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Back to the ground with Robinson. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
That 2nd down play call was not to pick up the 1st down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable 3rd down because they had incompletion on 1st down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. Throwing is Cousins. Finding Moore on the out route for the completion. Touchdown, Falcons! Rondale Moore, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons are an extra point away from evening this one up. Well, on that connection, it looked like they maybe had some pre-play communication. Maybe one of them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that great silent communication that you just noticed right there because the best quarterback receiver combos in the NFL, they know how to make those adjustments at the line of scrimmage when they see something pre-play, and they got it done there.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And the Falcons score to cap it off. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this is not going to wind up anywhere near the landing zone, so this will be blown dead, and they'll move it up to the 40. Baltimore's offense set for this next possession. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight-ahead running for just a couple of yards, 2nd down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Now Jackson taps his forward jet sweep, and that is not fooling anyone. He never had a chance to turn the corner there, and they'll go backwards right away. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up. It's 7. Here's 3rd and 9. Now Jackson. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on 3rd down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. This will be a 41-yard punt, 3 on the return.
And it will be Falcon football.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now, ready to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Throwing, Cousins. And this will be caught by Mooney. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Right off the bat, it's a 1st down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Any questions of how they'd approach this drive were answered right there. They come out throwing, and they get a nice pickup here toward the end of the first half.
First down, here's Cousins. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Now a dump off here complete, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down.
We often talk about understanding the playbook, understanding progressions, and understanding what the defense is doing. We saw all of that on that play. Great recognition, and understood where his running back was going to be. Found a way to have him leak out underneath, hit him with the football, and they picked up the 1st down.
To the air again, it's Cousins. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect and try and pick up another 1st down.
Throwing again, Cousins, on 2nd and 10. This pass is caught by London, and he's going to be taken down with the 1st down at the Ravens' 15-yard line. The Falcons going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Cousins. He's going to drop this underneath for Robinson. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 11 more on that one, and another 1st down.
It's all pretty simple sometimes, isn't it? Go where the defenders are not, and he does exactly that. Makes a nice catch to move the chains. Defense got to find a better way of accounting for the shorter routes that are being run against them.
That ball is caught. It's London for the Atlanta touchdown. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Falcons will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Koo now for the point after. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told.
And it was finished off by a touchdown catch from Drake London. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. And the Ravens going to get one more drive here in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. To throw is Jackson. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Second down and 3. Here's Jackson on the move to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Here is third and 5. Here's Jackson to throw. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Out now is the punter, Jordan Stout.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. So we have reached halftime now with the visiting Falcons out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Raven offense set to start this third quarter. Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down.
Now that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained. And, in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
They run the option here on first and 10.
And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
Ball placed at the 45 for second and 5.
Off the option, here's Henry. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here comes third down at 7.
Jackson now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
Has not been a big game for him throwing the football. I think he feels like, let's try something different. Let's use the legs here and see if we can make some plays.
And no passing touchdowns, yardage not where he would like it. Try something new. It worked there. A first down carry for Henry. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
A strong running. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a first down at the Falcons 36.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. This will be the 8th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and inches.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up,
and he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
Jackson going to run again.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It was Matt Judon that time who worked his way in to blow that play up.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up second and 12. little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11.
Fast, slow, it doesn't matter. If you give a quarterback enough room to escape, he can hit you for a big gain. You've got to give him a little more focus moving forward.
Here now, third and a yard. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's a big letdown defensively. They had him stopped behind the line, but the face mask going to bail the offense out.
And the hand does not have to be up there for too long. Just a little bit of a grab is going to be enough to get the call and the 15 yards against him.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
They work now on second and 9. Jackson going to keep it running right. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. This offense so far on third down, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. Now Jackson going to take off with it. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky.
Well, he's had success running the football in this one. Yeah, that's undeniable. But that time, the defense was on to it.
And partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations and looks.
Tucker's kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So an interesting call there to take the 3. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the air.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, second and 6.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Now Cousins. And that went to the right side and incomplete.
I like his awareness in the pocket there. Nowhere to go with the football. So instead of forcing it to the sideline, he's just going to put this one into the harbor.
and live to fight another down without getting wet.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Cousins now. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. When that ball popped free, we could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on it.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
Yards on the punt, give him just 1 yard on the return, and the Ravens will take over. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game. First and 10 here. They begin with Henry. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
From the 25, here's second and six. Throwing is Jackson. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Play action. Now Jackson. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Oh, no, he lost the football. Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
On second down, here's Jackson. The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Here comes second down at five. Now it's Jackson. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So the defense helping him out a little bit here late in the fourth.
Man, you're exactly right. And when you're the one doing the chasing, you'll take a little help from the other guys, won't you?
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now.
Jackson.
This will be caught inside the 10. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
Brandon's okay with what they're doing right now. Still able to work the middle of the field, but you know, sooner or later, they're going to have to stop the clock.
Here's first and goal.
53.
Now Jackson.
Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
On second down, here's Henry. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. An incompletion, now a short pickup. That's not going
to
do it.
Yeah, you've got to get to the line of scrimmage quickly, get set up, and aim downfield.
For the lead, here's third and goal. Jackson. There's Flowers. He's got it. Touchdown, Ravens.
A one-yard touchdown pass. And the Ravens have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
Charles, what a big drive late in the fourth quarter to take this lead.
And normally you're really excited if your offense has the ball late in the game. But I think this crew is really excited to have their defense go back out there because they haven't surrendered a point in the fourth quarter yet. They've helped make this comeback possible with their defensive play. Now they get a chance to finish this game off.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
From the end zone, here comes Williams. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
So Kirk Cousins in the offense. Down 17-14, a little under a minute to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Cousins to throw.
Gets this to Moore.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
They come up now on second and 2. They'll run this one right with Robinson. And that could be a killer. He'll lose yardage and tackled inbounds.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this fourth quarter.
This definitely four down territory at this point, but a critical third down here.
Cousins.
London hauls this one in.
And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Who wants it more? This is 4th and a yard.
They'll run for it with Robinson. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape.
Partner, when you see a running play stop short like that, you just know that the defensive front, they won the battle of leverage and created the push back into the opposing backfield.
And for the offensive coordinator, whether you had 1 yard to go or 20 yards to go on fourth down, now you're probably saying, oh, maybe I should have passed it, right?
Yeah, hindsight is always 20-20.
The Ravens taking a knee with victory seemingly in hand here. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Down to a knee goes Jackson, and that should seal it.
Partner, they took a knee to finish this one off. To me, that's the only thing they lost in the fourth quarter. How about that comeback?
Yeah, trailed coming into the last frame. Got it done, taking the knee. Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.